This is the e-reader, one of Nintendo's peripherals, and the idea with the e-reader was to plug it into your Game Boy Advance and to swipe some cards that would unlock some special games and stuff. Super Mario Advance 4, Super Mario Bros. 3 had this functionality, and it allowed players to try 38 exclusive new levels. And you guessed it, today we'll be playing those e-reader levels without touching a single coin. The rules are simple. We are going to be playing all 38 levels from World E, and we'll attempt to beat them without touching a single coin. You see the coin counter up there? Well, we want to keep it at zero. Alright, now that everything has been set, make sure to subscribe and let's just jump into it! We'll begin this quest with the Star Cards, and Star-1 is a remake of World 1-1 from Super Mario Bros. And I played this level quite a lot in the past, so obviously by now you all know that as long as you don't enter this pipe to reach the secret bonus room full of coins, then you'll be all good. Star-2 is a remake of 1-2. And it kind of feels weird to play this in the Super Mario Bros. 3 engine. I did try to get on top of the level, to get on top of the blocks and skip it all, but those coins didn't allow me to do so. I played it normally, and it was pretty easy. You know what, I'm starting to wonder if all of the e-reader levels are just remakes of Super Mario Bros. 1, as Star-3 is yet again a remake of the first game. It's a remake of 1-3 to be exact. Just be careful of the few coins on the way and a couple scary jumps you have to do, and you'll be good. Guess what? Star-4 is actually 1-4 from the original Mario, and as you can probably remember if you watch my previous videos, there are no coins on the way besides these Le Epic Troll hidden blocks. Avoid them, defeat Bowser, and you'll get a frog suit! Yay, huh? Star-5 is the final remake level, and this one's a remake of 2-2, so it is an underwater stage. Swimming to dodge coins is quite easy. It's the bloopers that are actually difficult to dodge and ruining my life! Next up are the mushroom cards, which hopefully won't be remakes of Super Mario Bros. Levels. Mushroom-1 takes place in the sky. And the first part is actually an auto-scroller, so it's kind of tricky. I'm also afraid of coins that are out of the screen, as the Game Boy Advance screen resolution is super low, so the game is like super zoomed in compared to the SNES version. Still, if you're being careful, this one is actually possible. In Mushroom 2, this first part wants you to slide and jump, but there are so many coins on the way! Thankfully, there is a leaf inside of that block. So just get rid of all of the enemies, start running, start flying, and you'll reach the end easily. Mushroom 3 is quite the weird level. There are some charging chucks from Super Mario World, and you can actually pluck veggies from the ground like you can in Super Mario Bros. 2. Man, these e-reader levels are kind of creative, eh? Coin-wise, this level doesn't feature too many and is quite easy to beat. Mushroom 4 was a wild ride. It's full of doors all over the place, and I wasn't sure what to do with it, as I was just getting lost in this ghost house. That was until I just flew up in the sky and entered this hidden door to fight the Boo from Super Mario World. Yup, it's the exact same fight where you have to grab some blocks and throw them at the Boo. Huh, that's neat. Mushroom 5 is an airship level where you actually enter the ship and keep playing the stage. There were lots of annoying coins to dodge, but the real annoyance came from the bombs scattered all over the place. Mushroom-6 features a lot of those note blocks, so get ready to bounce all the time, but there are no coins thankfully. This one actually plays like a bad Super Mario Maker level, to be fair. Mushroom 7 was odd, as the only challenge came from running fast on those blocks before they turn back into yucky coins and you fall down in the lava. Besides that, it's actually quite easy. Mushroom 8 is all about plants attacking you out of pipes. Sure, there's a couple of coins to avoid here and there, but it's not too difficult, so you'll be okay. Mushroom 9 features a lot of fire, lava, and enemies in this castle, but not a lot of coins. Just be careful and you'll soon reach the boss, who's actually Boom Boom the Mad Lad. Times 2, huh, Who knew Boom Boom had a twin? Now this is epic. Mushroom 10 asks you to hop on some para-beetles, but as you can see, the screen scrolls really, really fast, and all of those beetles are actually located under those coins, so you kinda have to collect a bunch in order to beat the stage. So this one is not possible. Mushroom 11 is yet another level with musical notes all over the place. Just why? Mushroom 12 is full of enemies, cannonballs, and other things attacking you. There's not a lot of coins though, so we're all good. Mushroom 13 features two very tricky jumps. This first one where you have to go above the coins, and then this one where you need to be small Mario in order to fit under the coins. Very scary level, but possible to beat. Mushroom 14 is a very short level. You have to do insane jumps under coins at the beginning, and it's very scary looking, but after that, well, just run to the right and the end of the stage will be waiting for you, so that's nice. Man, these e-reader levels keep getting weirder and weirder, as Mushroom 15 features a feather cape from Super Mario World! Yes, the Super Mario World power-up in the Super Mario Bros. 3 engine! What? And you need to do a very precise run and jump to fly up there and beat the stage. This took me many attempts to dodge all of those coins on the way, but eventually I managed a way to do it. But still, I have a feather cape in Mario 3! Like, that blows my mind! Mushroom 16 is a castle level that starts off with you falling from a pipe onto a P-switch that turns coins into blocks and makes a bunch of silverish coins appear. In order to beat this part, well, you need to do a very precise jump to get to a platform as the silver coins disappear, but at the same time, those blocks turn into yellow coins, so the timing is very precise and oh so difficult, but it is possible. Sadly, once this part is done, well, your problems are not over, as you'll soon reach this part where you need to use a Goomba shoe to jump on Thwomps. And sadly, there are way too many coins to get through this, so this one is not possible. Mushroom 17 is a weird level featuring the penguins from Yoshi's Island and a couple more enemies from Super Mario World. Seriously, what is up with this game? Was this the original Super Mario Maker game, mixing up enemies from all over the place and no one knew about it? The weirdest thing in this level is that custom scrolling screen at the end. It keeps scrolling left and right, and you just have to crouch to avoid the coins, but eventually the screen will move back right and will allow you to proceed and go in the pipe. This level just doesn't make any sense, but whatever. In Mushroom 18, all of the coins are actually frozen solid, so just don't grab that fire flower over there and you'll be all good. Mushroom 19 is an easy level. It does feature a couple of coins, but we can actually avoid those without any problem. Mushroom 20 features one very difficult part where you need to jump in between some coins. As you can see, it's quite the precise jump. But yeah, once you clear this part, well, the rest is actually easy. Mushroom 21 is one of those levels where you have to keep running like a mad lad to the right. Sadly, I tried many ways to get through this first jump, but we actually need to touch some coins, as there's no way to go above or under them. So yeah, this level is not possible. Mushroom 22 is full of ropes to climb on, which is actually a mechanic from Super Mario Bros. 2. There's a bunch of coins to avoid on the way, but by being careful and actually planning ahead, you can do it. Mushroom 23 doesn't have that many coins, and the very few you can see can easily be avoided. On the other hand, Mushroom 24 is insanely difficult. Basically, you need to grab a feather cape and find a way to get enough speed to jump on top of those blocks over there. Then, you need to fly in between two rows of evil coins in the sky. Near the end, you have to let go, or else you'll stumble on some big arrows made out of coins. And that's not all. Once you're at the end over there, you'll have to defeat those annoying Lakitus and their spinies, or else they all turn into yucky coins when you grab the end card. This level was actually a real pain in the butt, and I'm so glad it's done. In Mushroom 25, you need to dig just like you do in Super Mario Bros. 2. This will force you to dig left and right to avoid the coins, and then you'll have to make your way up and keep dodging a couple coins, but to be fair, this is quite easy. Mushroom 26 is a very difficult level. There are lots of fire bars underwater and annoying coins all over the place. Some parts were insanely tricky, forcing you to swim in between coins and those spinning bars that can send you flying all over the place at high speed. Eventually, after many tries, I did clear it though. Mushroom 27 is a castle level, and this one is actually difficult because of lava, statues, and other hazards. But for this quest, well, it doesn't feature a lot of coins, so at least this is not an issue. Mushroom 28 will force you to remain small Mario if you intend to get under those coins over there. But actually, once this part is done, well, the rest of the level is quite easy. Mushroom 29 doesn't feature a single coin, so this one is a total joke. The same thing can be said about Mushroom 30. This level has no coins either. Let's just defeat Bowser, and with that done, all of the Mushroom levels are actually complete, and all that is left for us to do are the PR levels. PR-1 is yet another airship level, and this one has very few coins, so no worries, you'll be okay. PR-2 gives you a very strict time limit to beat it, and to do so, we need to keep running super fast, and we actually have to get coins along the way, so for this quest, this level is not possible. PR-3 is actually a very easy level that doesn't feature tons of coins, so we can easily clear this one. So, is it possible to beat the e-reader levels in Super Mario Bros. 3 without touching a single coin? Well, sadly, no. Out of the 38 card levels, 4 were actually impossible to clear. But to be fair, that still leaves 34 that were actually completed. So in my book, this is a win. Plus, those 4 levels are actually cards that we could easily lose, or maybe even cut in half. Thanks a lot for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, make sure to click the like button and to subscribe and tap the cards on screen to see more videos. As for me, I'll see you in the next one. Bye-bye!